welcome back to the sixth and the last session of connectivity. Hope you liked the previous videos and enjoyed experimenting with insertion of records and also seen how the format function works. Coming back today, in this lab session, we are going to do updation of records using format function. Fine. Before we proceed, let's look at the logic. Basically, I would like the updation of records to be done on a valid admission numbers only. So these are my valid admission number. Before updation, I would be checking whether the admission number which I'm going to provide is existing in the table or not. So if it is not existing, so that means I will raise up an error that this was not a valid admission number. And if it is existing, I will be definitely switching on to updation. And if I say updation, I will be entering the new score for the student and updating. So what are we waiting for? Let's code. Okay, as always, I have some pre-written code so that we are not wasting the time on it. My connection object is ready, my cursor object is ready. Now the basic focus is on updation. I'll be providing an admission number, I'm going to provide a new score, and that new score should be updated to the table. So for updating, we know the query used is going to be update student set score is equal to the score which is a new score, where admission equal to the admission number which I want to have. Fine. Score is given in S and X is the admission number. So remember, this S goes over here and this X goes over here. Fine. So my query is ready, and as I say, before executing the query, please print and ensure that your query is made properly. That's a very good practice. Okay, so my admission number is say 123 and my score is 14. Update students, set score is equal to 14, where admission number equal to 123. Okay, perfect. My query for updation is perfectly okay. But if you recollect, this has to be executed only if it's a valid admission number. So I've already shown you the table before. These are the valid admission numbers, but right now, this is the admission number which I am giving, which is invalid. Okay, so if I'm going to execute this, what is going to happen? Say cursor dot execute, and this is the query. Query is executed. I'm deleting this off. I'm giving an invalid number 123, and the score is also given. See, there is no error, nothing is being given over here. So this is not an interactive program. This is not a user-friendly program. If the admission number is invalid, it has to show it is invalid, right? So what needs to be done over here is you have to improvise your code so that we can think about the previous logic. Fetch the record, see whether the fetch is successful or not. And if it is successful, then only you proceed with this kind of updation. Okay, so let's go. So what is required here is, after inputting the admission number, okay, I'm not going to update anything. I am going to check whether the admission number is available or not. So my query is going to be to fetch a record with respect to this admission number. So already I have used the query, and I'm going to use another value, query one. Okay, so let it be select star from students where admno is equal to, what's the admission number? Of course it's in X, so I'm simply concatenated. So here you can see both the examples I'm concatenating and using the format function. Whichever is comfortable, you can use it. Fine. So let me execute this query. So cursor dot, please execute the query, execute this query. What is the name query? Here it is, query one. Fine. Not the query, it's query one. So query one is executed, and I'm going to fetch the record cursor dot. How many records? Yes, it's fetch one. So fetch one executes a record. I'm ready with the record set. Now let me see, what does the fetch one do? If a record is found, then it will be giving you the tuple. And if the search is unsuccessful, it returns none. Fine. So that none is going to be used over here. R is equal to and none. Fine. So none is done. And hereafter, I am going to print error message invalid admission number debug part. Okay. Else means, well, if there is admission number which is available, there is a record set which is available, then of course I can proceed with the updation. The entire this part goes in the else part. So I'm going to enter, if the admission number is valid, I'm going to enter the new score, I'm going to update it, and I'm going to execute this query. So I can make it query 2 so that you will not be confused with both the queries. So this is query number 2 is executed if the admission number is valid. Fine. Let me save and show you the execution. Say 1, 2, 3. Invalid admission number. Cool. So my job is done. Alt F5 and then again. What was the admission number? 2010101. Fine. Yes. So this is a valid admission number. So I can update the score. So currently you can see Anu is scoring 45 and I'm going to change the score. So make it 55. Fine. So enter. So you can give a print message as well. This one, and you can see, oh, it's 45 here. What happened? Yeah, anybody? Yes, I forgot to write my commit statement. Okay, so cursor.execute. The TCL command have been forgotten, so it was not committed. Alt F5 2010101. New score is 55. Fine. Let me check out with my SQL part now. So that was a successful updation. Anu got 55. Okay, so that brings to the end of today's session. Hope it was exciting. So what are we waiting for? Just grab your computers, keep practicing. Happy coding. Thank you.